Well, good morning. It is in the top five most watched Netflix shows in the world. Taking you straight back to high school, take a look.
Best friend, dumb me!
I'm a reject!
I have a lazy kebab vagina!
Boy, there's a fully gut sex map in the old stairwell!
Joke, right?
I'm way funnier than this.
Do you not understand how unimportant it all is?
That's not a reason to dump me.
Oi, hello, didn't you hear me?
Bloody love you. We're gonna stick to
me. Everyone hates me.
Oi, Amory! Psycho map!
We don't hate you.
You just need to strut out there and earn your
Heartbreak High was a hit for teens back in the 90s and played here on 10, and it's been reimagined for a fresh generation. And stars of this astronomical reboot, Chika, Ayesha and James, join us on Studio 10. I'm so excited for this. I've been like a total groupie hanging out with you all and feeling their energy. How much fun did you have making Heartbreak High, Chika?
Oh, we had a little bit of fun. We're a little bit cheeky. We knew each other a bit before shooting, so it was so special to be able to share those, you know, those moments with such good friends.
It's so rare to get that opportunity to work with some of your closest friends, and I feel like that really translates on the screen with our chemistry. We're so lucky.
There is so much chemistry, and you can feel it. I can feel it just hanging out with the three of you. Chika, but you play a teacher in the front of the classroom. How hard was it to take command of this most incredible group of actors, students?
Students. They're the worst students, I think, in the history of time. No, they were really amazing. And I think, just because we knew each other beforehand, there'd be moments on set where we would make just a little bit too much eye contact and just the lip would start quivering, but it was actually...
Was that you?
Well, I actually have a story. When Chika first got the role, we had a group FaceTime and laughed for, I want to say, 5 minutes straight. We didn't say a word. We were just laughing.
Yeah.
So I think that's indicative of how the shooting went.
Yeah.
The whole show is so incredibly groundbreaking. It's called Heartbreak High, but there's not really any similarities to the 90s show. It smashes all of the stereotypes that anyone has ever had of all the characters. And I think that's the beauty of it, James. Is that, you know, how do you kind of describe what it does to stereotypes?
I feel what's so amazing about this show is, like, it's quite a diverse cast, but what's so interesting about these characters is that their diversity isn't the most interesting thing about them. It's just a fact.
Mm.
We spoke about just, like, looking around the room or the classroom on set and feeling like it actually felt like an Australian classroom for us. So it felt true and honest, which was a big privilege, but it never felt like we were trying to push this diversity message. It's just what an Australian classroom looks like.
Yeah, and Ayesha, there's so much success around the world, and is that and also in Australia, it's number two in Australia for the second week in a row, and it debuted on number six in the world for Netflix, and now it's in the top five in its second full week around the world, which is incredible. Do you think that the success is because people are seeing themselves?
Well, definitely. I think for such a long time, a lot of Australians were robbed of that experience of being able to see themselves on screen, and I think the success of the show is completely, completely reflective of its diversity and people finally being able to relate to the characters and see, I mean, somewhat their stories told on screen.
Yeah.
So I think it's quite special.
And Chika, when we meet as an audience, when we meet all the characters, no one is really as we expect them to see because we haven't seen it before.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, is that a lot of the feedback that you're getting?
Yeah, definitely. I think, like James was saying before, like the diversity is the least interesting thing about the characters. Everyone brings something so nuanced and so specific and something that we haven't seen before, which is, really exciting to see on Australian screens, just the breaking of those stereotypes.
Subverting what we think is a norm.
Exactly.
What is normal.
Yeah, definitely shifting away from that. And creating our new normal, hopefully, and hopefully this can be a starting point for future programs.
Yeah, and as James said, it's what these are what classrooms look like.
Yeah,
these are what actual schools look like in Australia and around the world. And James, there is a classic scene, which I absolutely love, that non-binary folks around the world will relate to. We've got a little scene to show you. Let's have a look.
You around tonight, are you?
Why?
Oh, nothing, just the boys are coming over to watch the game, is all.
Okay, and you want me to not be around?
He always assumes the worst.
Mm-hmm. It might be. They always assume the worst.
This again, I mean, it's exactly my point. My mates can't be expected to get their heads around this stuff.
Oh, this scene is so relatable because there are family members and people all over who are learning how to gender correctly and use pronouns correctly. And I just think it's such a beautiful way to do it, like in a home environment. I mean, was that kind of the special part of being able to play your character?
Totally. I mean, it's so fun. I mean, like, the most beautiful part or the result of the show is just the messages from people who've been able to sort of see themselves in Darren, which has been really special. And lots of people, I mean, it's been so overwhelming. I try not to cry on morning television, but people who have, like, reached out and have been like, Darren helped me realise who I am, and that is, I feel like, why we do it. It's so special, and it also comes down to our brilliant writers who offered us this rare opportunity to be able to share a little bit of ourselves in each of our characters. I mean, just the creative lease that they've given us has been really special, and it's translated so specially and beautifully.
Oh, it really has. And we had Chloe Hayden on Studio 10 not long ago as a neurodivergent actor playing a neurodivergent character. And, you know, you're the same playing a non-binary character. I mean, how important is it to bring lived experience into your role, Chika? How important is that?
Yeah, I think it's so important. Like, we need to see more specificity in these roles, and I think, like Ayesha mentioned, that's a large part of why the show has been so successful, is that the more specific, you know, we've gotten and the more specific the creators have gotten, the more universal these characters and the more relatable these characters are. So, yeah, hope to see a lot more of that in the future. Yeah.
And Ayesha, you tackle some really heavy topics that is just, you know, normal life, but every character feels it in their own way and deals with things in their own way.
Yeah, totally. I mean, Amory definitely has quite a tumultuous time throughout season one. But I think it's really special. I think a lot of it just has to do with being a teenager. It doesn't actually have to do with really the fact that she's a brown woman or anything like that. I think it's just anything that a teenager can relate to is stuff that Amory's gone through. And hopefully, I mean, already I've gotten, like, DMs from teens, like you said, just being like, wow, like, this is exactly what I went through, and I feel less alone. So
that's the biggest compliment you can get, isn't it?
It really is.
And Ayesha, you're also a music artist. Tell us about your new single, Goldfish.
Well, I've just released a single called Goldfish, and it's on Spotify and Apple Music and all the rest. So I've been making music for a long time. I suppose that's kind of my main shtick, and it's just so exciting to finally get more music out into the world and start playing shows, and I'm just excited to release more stuff as time goes on.
So yeah. And what about releasing a second season of Heartbreak High? Do we have to start a movement?
Maybe.
Yes. Everyone will just have to keep streaming it.
So we get more season 2. I miss you already. I miss you already. Chika, Ayesha and James, it's so lovely to have you on Studio 10. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You've
become part of our, in part of our lives. And if you haven't watched Heartbreak High, what are you even doing? Number 5 in the world for Netflix. That is just incredible. And it's part of who you are as people that you've brought into these characters and the writing team and everyone that's a part of Heartbreak High. So congratulations.
Thank you so much.